Hey guys, this is Adolph Gaming. We're ready to get back into the action with Twilight Princess. We are almost to the end of the game. So, here's what we gotta do. There is one heart piece out in the world. We're gonna grab that one really quick. There are two heart pieces in the next dungeon. We will be getting those at the appropriate times. Hold on, I gotta think where this thing is at. It's not that bridge. Shit. It is... Yes. Okay, so there's one heart piece here, and then there's two heart pieces in the next dungeon. Now, I don't really like to think of the next level as a dungeon, because when we get there, you're going to notice that it's a lot different than the other dungeons. Which is kind of an oxymoron, because all of the dungeons have been pretty unique up to this point. So it's not really fair to say that this is not a dungeon, because it clearly is. There's going to be a map and a compass and a big key. But, it's just not quite the same to me. Okay, before we go down there to get that, I'm going to blow this up. I'm greedy and I want the rubies. I want to see how long it takes us to max out at 2,000. We're not able to do this before, but we can do this now. It is a double claw shot mess to get over to this hidden chest that has a heart piece. Now, I find it interesting that this is here, because there was a heart piece literally just sitting up on the cliff side way a long time ago. So, it looks like we're pretty well on track for where we need to go. We're up to 40 postals. We just need one good cleanup episode to get the rest. But I'm not really in the mood for that right now. We have two things to do in town. First off, now that we have the double claw shot, we are ready to take on the Stars minigame for the second time. This time it's going to be a little more trickier, but if you know what you're doing, you're going to be able to have no problem whatsoever with it. After that, we are going to head to the bar, because that's going to give us our next hint on what the hell is up. I actually don't think we need to go to the bar, to be honest. Actually, screw the bar. We don't need to go to the bar. I really wish I could skip all of those cutscenes. Now, just to make sure that I'm not missing something, we will go ahead and check that mail. So I might have used Oko at some dungeon. I think the Water Temple, maybe. I don't know. Maybe it was in a previous playthrough. But if you use her, her son teleports you out, and she stays where she's at. And then when you want to go back, the son teleports you back to her. The son wanted to say, hey, thanks, good job, and all that other stuff with the dragon and all that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to skip his garbage dialogue because it doesn't matter. We got to be quick as snot, and we cannot hit the ground at any point. Okay. Yeah. The colored lights give you an indication of where you want to go. If you manage to hit all these little lights in a row, you'll go wild. Don't freak out. And you don't even have to really go in order. So long as you're hitting a good number of these things, you're good, because it's just going to do a little bit of cleanup at the end. And of course, if you were trying to do this without a claw shot, especially without the double claw shot, it would be virtually impossible. I know you can fluidly do this in one easy motion, I just don't have all the paths memorized. The colors kind of dictate where you need to go. But like I said, you do not have to be perfect at this. That clearly wasn't perfect. There we go. I'm sure somebody has set the world record for like nailing that in like 5 seconds or whatever. We got the giant quiver, 100 arrows. We link that up with all our bombs. We've got tons and tons of artillery, which we will need for the Cave of Trials, but we don't need it right this second. And of course, the girls will allow if you talk to them. They drop some hearts, they coo, and then they run away. Let's see. I don't believe we need to head to the bar for anything, but unfortunately, I can't teleport while in the city. There are some parts we can get to for stamps or pose. We have all of the tools that are necessary to get all of them. I'm probably gonna say it in like every video up until we're finished. I'm not that interested in the posums. If you guys want a full collection of the wrap-up for the posums, I want to see comments that say, hey, do this. If I can get like a good gigantic helping of that, then I will be inspired to do that. I'm not gonna do it if nobody else wants me to. If nobody cares, then I'm not worried about it. If you guys want a full complete guide on literally anything in this game, I would really suggest BeeBear's videos. I've said it before, BeeBear has got some excellent work. There's no commentary to his guides, but he's got a guide for the game, a guide for all the extras, a guide for all the collectibles, very straightforward and cut-through. If you guys want that, go check out his channel. For me, this is just for completion. I think the one fang is cute when she's smiling. Not like that. Come to think of it, that beast had to have dragged us for miles to lock us up in the prison. Jesus.
Thank you.
know, they could have, like, given us some power or items or bottles or something. They expect us to do all this work and not put anything into it for us. This will be my third dungeon clear of today. Normally I only get to one, maybe two dungeons on my days off, and I still have to work tonight. If I didn't have to work tonight, I'd have killed the whole game by midnight, I'm so sure, but let's see what she has to say.
This is my death. My ends. To dead and end. Stretch and end. Up to death. Fortress and winter death. You end.
To me, these look like the rejects that Zant didn't want fighting in his army. Because we got, like, short and fat and super tall and kind of skinny. So, okay, this is how this works. There's three buildings here. This is the town of Twili. I don't know. So, to me, it doesn't really feel like a dungeon because it's their home. And there's, like, NPCs outside. So, to me, it's kind of odd to say that this is a dungeon, but I'm gonna treat it like a dungeon. These things are copies of Zant's helmet, and they are very freaking annoying because they teleport and they just don't seem to die. Now, we're gonna have to kill these every time we see them. It's just kind of a requirement for everything because most of the time they're hiding chests and such. This one was hiding a small key. There is a heart piece in this room that we are not capable of grabbing. We also have hookshot points, and I'm so glad we have the double hookshot right before we came here because we're going to be needing it. This dungeon is fairly easy. It's very straightforward, but it's very easy to make a mistake. If you use your senses, you can see through the smoke a lot easier. This is the first time in the entire game, and I think the only time in the entire game, that killing something generated two chests at once. I believe this is the dungeon map. Compass, how weird. This dungeon is set up, and I'm talking about the entirety of the dungeon, not just, like, the little bits. It's set up to accommodate very nicely. It is very single room, next, next. I don't know if I can hit this straight up, or if I have to hit this one first. Looks like I have to hit that one first. This is really easy to miss, because you're not really paying attention. But there's a chest up here. Now, you also notice platform. You will be utilizing that platform over there. And we got the Angry Midna stamp. I'm gonna try to collect everything that is in this area, because honestly, I don't think we will ever be coming back here. Thank you. you're going to have to repeat this twice, which sucks, but that's okay. First things first, mini boss fight. Pretty quick for a boss fight, right? So check this out, this is Phantom Zant. He's a total pushover, very weak, very easy. We're gonna kill him in like nothing. But he likes to create buttholes in the sky. Still. And even if he teleports right next to you, he's just gonna keep teleporting. If you let him get the attack off, he gets to summon his allies back. If you're fast, he doesn't get the chance to. But he teleports many, 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 many times. Shit. Good, I got him in time. Does this kamikaze crap to summon this black smoke, and you're like, oh god, what am I gonna do? Weak ass shit. So, just run around it, because it's not worth the time to waste transforming into transforming. So, here's how this section of it goes. She's just gonna tell us that this is the light of soul. It's very important, and it can restore my people and all that stuff. So, slice the hand. Pick up the orb. Throw said orb. Drop said orb. Now, this is the creepiest portion of the entire game, and I hate it. It's not really that creepy to look at, but it's creepy, okay? So, every Zelda game has this particular enemy. They are extremely well hated, because they're super annoying, super intense, and honestly, they scare the shit out of people sometimes. So here's how this one works. The way this one works is its job is to guard this fucking orb. You need to get this orb outside to the center area that we were just in a few minutes ago. It's gonna come and take it from you if you're too slow. We have to use this orb to open up pathways to get back to the front door, which means letting go of it. So here it is to come take back the orb. It's this creepy-ass looking satanic hand. So you want to be really quick. Now, enemies are going to get in the way. Just kind of pray that they aren't. You can honestly ignore them for the most part, even though they're totally jumping at you. He can phase through objects. He just doesn't give a shit. So, as usual, I'm going to avoid enemies when possible. If you throw this too hard, you can bounce it back down and you're in like a world of hurt. Okay, first room cleared, super easy. This room, not too bad either, but this is where our heartbeats is, and we have to use this orb in order to, well, we technically can come back later, but we're gonna do it now, because I prefer to get the shit done. And there's no way he got through the wall that quickly. Enemies don't really care. Drop it there. He's not all that quick. I thought I could jump off that. He's not all that quick, so we do have enough time for this. Okay. The reason this is quick tricky is because it gives you an invisible time limit in a way that you can alter. There's the next heart piece. One more container for the final heart piece that we can collect. So... damn it. This thing will also roll downhill, which is not all that hard. Something hits you, you're screwed. We made it out, we're safe, we're good. The reason that I personally hate this thing, it's one of the creepiest enemies in the entire Zelda franchise, is because they're masked differently in the older games. The older games, they're super creepy looking. They're even worse than that thing, like really freaky. And I can't remember what they're called. Master hands, dark hands, ghoul hands, claw hands. So this is what the orb does. We could run around and heal all the citizens, but if the light leaves the area or they aren't close enough to it for a while or we leave the area, then it's just gonna go poof anyway, so it doesn't really matter. We're gonna do that. It's gonna activate the lid. lift. I'm kind of surprised it activated the lift, considering it's in the far one. She's just going to say, we need to go get the second one. And now we use platforms. So the reason those things are super creepy to me is in previous Zelda games, typically in creepy-ass dungeons, those Master Claw hand things will jump out and snatch you out of nowhere. And the only indication that they're even coming is a small circular shadow underneath you that grows and grows and grows and grows and gets to a certain point, and then it just slams down on you and grabs you. Typically, you couldn't defend against them. Typically, they just kind of kicked your ass. Again, we're going to be doing a lot of claw shooting. This time, on the other hand, we're going to be doing it very differently. The next heart piece is also in this room. Oh god, don't you fucking dare, dude. So we can reflect his magic attacks, but because he's so far away, it's not going to do us any good. I wanted to test that because I didn't know if bombs could even damage them. Come on. Damn it! Should have seen it coming. Pretty sure he's still summoned, so he's gonna keep coming in. But I don't think he prefers to come this direction very much. So again, on those guys, the reason why they creep you out is because they come out of nowhere, they snatch you up really dramatically, and they put you at the beginning of the dungeon, which means you literally have to do the whole dungeon practically over again to get back to wherever the hell you were in the first place. What a bitch. Also, their magic attacks, I believe, just stun them. I don't believe they kill them at all. God, he's gonna be so annoying right now, aren't you? And of course, you're gonna hide out of a distance that I can't even get you. I'm gonna wait because I'm pretty sure if we kill him, a chest pops up and we need it for like a key or something. Hey, buddy. So they were really creepy and they screwed you over really badly. Yes, I was right. So that's why I hate those hands. They just creep me out so bad. They're so gnarly. They're just terrible, terrible fucking creations. Not even the creepiest creation in the whole Ocarina time. That was like a mini-boss that was just creepy as all hell in the village. Oh god, I don't even want to go there with that crap. But it was just awful. Again, we have a room with a lot of hook shots. I'm pretty sure we are going to be playing around with these hook shots. Now, we have these assholes. No more this time. I think I wanted to hint to you in the previous area about where the heart piece was, because how douchey would it be to make you re-go back through that entire fucking thing again? So, we're gonna hookshot around for a little bit. telling you right now, the dungeon is probably going to take up a total of an hour because there's a lot of platforming we got to deal with. Now, in this area, there's a whole bunch of treasure chests. One of them has, I believe, the dungeon map. Of course, I want to get that. One of them has a stamp. Some of them have rupees. I will go ahead and get all of these because I don't know what is in all of them. Probably just rupees. 50 is still nice. It's good. We're getting our collection up, and since we haven't had to spend cash on, like, anything, we have some freedom to be able to collect it all. I know that chest is there, but we also have a chest here. God, what do you think of this? Oh, God! Lame. What happens when I'm not paying attention? Key. Okay, we definitely are good to go on that. We were gonna have to get that to get through the door. I forgot that this door is last dungeon, we faced the mini boss, and then right before the boss, we faced two clones of the mini boss. So it's kind of like a sub mini boss fight without a reward. This time is virtually the same experience, except instead of there being two, there's still only one. But I like this. I like that Link learned his lesson, that Link was paying attention. I don't like that Link is not ruthless enough to just cut his damn head off. Should have turned around and knifed him again. Shouldn't have let him produce another butthole in the sky. The hell, Link. This time, he creates decubabas everywhere. Now here's the deal. There is 0 point in trying to kill another one of these things. Phase, they disappear. There's no point in killing them all. You just put enough through there. And if you're quick, you don't give him the chance to spawn anything. And this goes a hell of a lot better. Unfortunately, he got one off because I wasn't paying enough attention. But he managed to stick around long enough. Actually, that one was extraordinarily fast compared to before. I've had to go another 2 or 3 runs of him teleporting before that ever happened. So that was pretty cool. Whatever speeds up the timer. Now, last time we took the orb and we got a heart piece with it. We can technically do that, but the problem is, it's really a time crunch at the last second, and there's a good chance this asshole could steal it back. Now, one thing that I didn't mention before about this guy is actually kind of cool. Drop that, it's gonna get into the path. We're actually gonna try to avoid dealing with that. Luckily, it's not really fast, so if you take your eyes off the prize, you're actually okay. And he likes to hover above it like an idiot instead of going right for the kill. If you fire 3 arrows at him, and I don't know how it applies to bomb arrows, But if you fire three regular arrows at him, you'll stun the hand for a good solid 15 seconds, I would say. We're probably going to be testing that here in a second. I call shenanigans because there's no way in hell he flew that fast versus the speed that he was flying at before. So, this time we brought the path up, but we gotta do a little bit of climbing. Now, this one is a little more intense because we have to use our hook shot to be able to get to where we need to go, and asshole is probably already. Got it. No, he didn't. Enemies really piss me off in this dungeon. Now, if he manages to hit that damn thing before I get a chance to, I'm going to be pissed. So we're gonna pause him. That's just my stomach. I'd be surprised if he didn't. And confused because he's really not going the right direction for this. Luckily, the claw shot has its own intelligence level to figure out how to grab things appropriately without shattering them. I imagine this thing is made out of glass. Okay. Scatter before it actually turned me into a wolf. Okay, so this time, just a tad tricky. Please don't pull down so I can't get you. I didn't know the claw shot took him down in one shot, otherwise I would have just used that. I am surprised he actually made it there that quickly. But then I saw the light moving and I was like, oh no you don't! So, we are outside and we get the tool of this dungeon. Now, this isn't a new tool, but it's really cool. I'm very happy that we're getting this. This is technically the last item in the game. Total, because there are no more tools to get. I don't even think there's any upgrades to get past this point. So we are really seriously like done. So this is going to give us something very special, something I don't believe has been in a Zelda game before. It's a power up for the Master Sword. It absorbs the light of soul and becomes this glowing blade of justice. This is cool. This is a damage boost. And if we use it around the Twilies, they turn into their normal self. And it gives us the ability, like she said, to repel the shadows. So all that crap coming down from the waterfalls, we can just go slice and it'll disappear. Now, we did not get the heart piece that was in here before. We are going to go get that right now. Not difficult, and it's in the first room, again, which is very, very nice. I believe there's a chest with rupees in it also, but who cares. You wouldn't think of it at the time unless you were paying attention to what's going on. I'm surprised enemies even want to come near you, considering they're like the denizens of darkness, and this is like a light force sword kind of thing. So, here's chest number one. I believe it's the rupees. Yes, another 50. We're gonna be maxed out here pretty soon. Now, what's funny is the sword cut through it, but it wasn't quick enough. And the shadows got us in wolf form. That is the final heart piece of the entire game. We have 19 hearts, and when we kill Zant, we are gonna get another one! And then that will be maxed for the very final heart container, and I'm stoked. I did a playthrough of this, and I've said this in a previous video, but in case somebody hasn't heard, or I just feel like ranting some more, shoot, we gotta go back here. I played through this, and I got to the end, and right about now, I looked at the heart pieces and thought, something's wrong, because I was missing a heart piece, don't know where. And I searched and searched and searched and still couldn't find it. And that's the middle save file in case anybody's actually been paying attention. But I was also missing a full heart container. Now, you could say I either missed one of the boss heart containers, which I really honestly don't think I did, or I missed five more heart pieces. I know this game well enough that I would not have just randomly lost track of six heart pieces. I know this game well enough, and I've got reference material to know that that wasn't the case, but what trips me out, and that I can't understand, is I went back and I watched all of my previous videos, and for some reason, it looked like I had gotten every heart piece container from the bosses, so I was like, screw it, this doesn't work for my plan, it makes the video look weak, let's just restart the whole thing. One, because I wanted a complete walkthrough and guide, minus postals and stamps, unless people want it. That's a bonus episode, but only if I get attention for it. And two, the wolf amiibo is the whole reason I did this. I wanted to get prepared for Breath of the Wild, and I wanted to be fully ready. I wanted to just be ready, you know? I wanted my wolf statue, because the wolf statue saves data on it. The data that it saves... I hope I don't turn into a wolf right this second. And I did. What the hell? So, the way the wolf statue works, and I'm going to say this when I actually do the guide for it, with the... I wish I could do, like, a blade attack that went flying with this, and, like, what I've seen in Skyward Sword. Anyway, so, the wolf statue has its own Cave of Trials thing. I've said this before, and I'm sure everybody knows about this. That was slick enough to kill them all like that. Not the prettiest, but at least it worked. So, with the wolf statue, you do this Cave of Trials thing, and it's like 40 levels of killing shit. And when you get through it, based upon how many hearts you had when you did it, dictate how many hearts are saved to the amiibo. Well, the wolf statue can be brought out during Breath of the Wild, and you can have your wolf-linked dude summoned into the game as a traveling companion to help you hunt and kill enemies. How freaking cool! So, of course, being the collectionist and the completist and everything like that that I am, I want my wolf maxed out. So getting to the end of the game with 18 hearts meant that was the most I was going to be able to put on the amiibo. I have got to have this thing at 20 hearts for this thing. I'm dying for it. So, that's how it works. So that's why I decided to redo all of this. Now, in the previous playthrough, I fucked up. The master key is right here, dude. But we need a key to get through here. Get the key to get through here. Thank you. guys die so easy with the life force sword over here. So, the last time I came through here, I screwed up so bad. I got this key, I went through the door, I made it all the way to the boss door, dude. And I didn't have the boss key. Oh, I was so pissed! Because it took forever to get up there. So, here's how this works. This should be a pretty clear hint, and I thought I had done what I needed to correctly. Now, unfortunately, I fucked that up, so we're gonna do it again. Come in here. Shots above me, so when I came behind the waterfall, I just thought it was bird enemies. And by the time I had done that, I was under the impression that, hey, maybe I'm supposed to kill all the birds to get the chest to spawn for the mini key. So I did that, and then I realized, oh wait, there's a platform over there. I went over there, and then the dudes came out. Oh god, it was retarded. I had the biggest brain fart ever. Oh boy. So now we're ready to take on the boss. We're doing pretty good on time, too. It's gonna take the full hour, but we're gonna get this done. I can taste it. So. Going to separate out into multiple platforms. The platforms go off into various different directions. If you choose the wrong platform, it will lead you on a trek around the room that's really stupid, and it's going to be a total pain in the ass. If you stay on a platform, it's likely to take you further and further away from your actual goal. Our actual goal is that one right there, but I want this dude to be dead. Thank you. get there. Damn it, we didn't make it in time because I had to deal with that fool. You fool! Gotta be this one. I don't know if you need to kill them all or not to get to that point, or to get that thing to spawn, but I just do it because I want the chest, because we need it for the small key. Oh god, I thought I was gonna make that. Having to go up the entire direction would have really, really sucked. So, in this next room, we've just got some bullshit, and then you can see that little pink dot. That little purple pink dot. And it means we're fucking some shit up. I love how this sword just one-shots the hell out of everything now. I'm pretty sure nobody revived at this point. This is just his royal guard coming to assault us. He's got nothing on us. Let's go take on Zant in one of the best boss fights of the game. And of course, it's at the end of the game, so it's gotta be climactic as shit, but it's so much fun! I wish I was on hard mode, because that would make it so challenging. Come here, fucker. Big long cutscene.
Thank you.
trippy. And now he's got his helmet back on. Let's get ready for it. Usurper King Zant is gonna get his ass kicked. I've been waiting the whole game to do this. Alright. That the reason why this thing is because it takes you back to your old Zelda moments throughout this game. We get to go back to all the old boss fights, not all of them, but most of them. And you typically have to use tools that you did before. I kind of think is a rip. I like the fact of what we're doing, but I really feel like this entire boss fight should have been the entirety of the boss fight. Spank that butt. Spank that butt. Like, we literally should have had to go to every single mini boss fight, every boss fight, we should have done them. So, he got really big, we smush his toe, he gets tinier than before. And then it's left over to me. enough, you're kind of screwed. Because he'll get big again. But we haven't had a boss fight here, you say. Well, this is going to be the end of it. And this is where it gets climactic and fun as shit. So, unfortunately, he gets a little bit of overpowered with those swords. You can kind of just cut right through him at that point. When he does this garbage, you get screwed a little bit because it'll slam you into the wall. You just want to create a situation where he burns himself out. Right. Seems like the more damage he's sustained at this point, the faster he pushes his garbage. Damn, he got a good hit on me. Now he's like super retarded fast. And if you hit the wall, you get zapped. I don't know if it does damage or not, though. Damn pot! Check out this cool shit. We got our weapon back. Spent all that time in the first three dungeons to get those, and we don't even get them until the very end. Zilla, bitch. Look at that shit. Midna's gotten stronger. She's got some nasty skills. I still say Midna should have her own game. I really, truly love Midna's design. Okay, here's the final heart container. We officially have 20. Fucking baller. There's nothing else we need. We never have to come back to this godforsaken Twilight Palace again. Although it's honestly got a pretty cool design to it. Blue's my favorite color, so seeing that inscribed everywhere is super sexy. Damn, right at 1 hour. And some change. So, it was great. I'm glad you guys joined me. I'm going to cut it here because I don't want to go past my time. Thank you guys so much. And in the next episode, we'll probably be cleanup. The way I'm going to set this up is we still have one major boss fight left, and that is the big ending.
with a look for them. And I'm doing to you and to you.
So we're going to save and we're going to quit here. Thank you guys for joining me. I hope you really liked it. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take a break for a little while. And in that break, I'm going to do Cave of Shadows and then Cave of Ordeals. And I'll record those two. And I'll probably put them at the very end of the series. And then I will come back and finish off the main host of the game. Because we get a little bit of treasure before then in the caves. And I'd like to kind of do that first to have for the boss fight. And then they'll still be posted after at the very end of the video. So thank you guys for joining me. It's been a blast, and I'm really hoping to finish this with you guys. Peace.